When Dennis and I are home for the holidays, we spend most of our time with our friends and family, but we also spend our downtime working on the RV. It's getting things repaired, making improvements, cleaning, organizing when you're on the road, traveling full-time. It's extremely difficult. And well, we've been on the road for quite some time now, meaning we have a lot of projects on our hands. We are gonna be pounding out as many projects as we possibly can, starting with getting the RV organized and giving her a clean. Because I will tell you what, Maggie is pretty gross right now. I'm honestly a little bit embarrassed. I wish we could say that this was unusual, but sadly, the RV looks like this 99% of the time. It's a small space, it gets dirty so quick, but I think we have been putting off a lot of organizing and cleaning just because we knew we were coming home. Gets this messy. This is just like piles of clothes we don't feel like putting away. We have had project boxes in the front seat, which holds like tools and things that we haven't found places for in the bay of our RV. And we keep the projects out because hopefully, right, maybe we'll do the projects that way.
What is this?
It's been 6 months, and every single time we move, I have to move the boxes from the front seats to the couch so that I can sit in the front seat. That's gonna go away today. You've got your coffee.
Yeah, round two. Gotta stay cracked out for this one.
New day of new projects. This one we have been wanting to do for quite a while.
It's been really moist. And since we sleep up there, it stays hot. So dark, hot, moist areas like to grow organic things called mold.
Ooh.
I'm gonna try to remediate it. I'm gonna clean everything. I'm gonna hit it with some bleach, hit it with some vinegar, seal it with some primer so that way it's not just bare wood. And then we're actually gonna lift the mattress about an inch using these tiles that are supposed to be for garden pots so you don't actually mess up your deck as they drain. But I've seen a DIY on the internet where you string them all together and cut them for the shape of the mattress. And then that allows airflow underneath the mattress so hopefully things stay dry. We'll see.
Yuck. Smells so bad.
Your eyes are burning?
Yes. This is a dirty job, guys. Dirty job. By dirty, I mean it's just vinegar, but it's very strong vinegar.
Got the Sirocco fan and the box fan kicking. When the platform's dry, then I get to paint it.
We knew the importance of having breathability between the mattress and the platform that the bed rests on. And for some reason, RV manufacturers don't seem to keep this in mind. A lot of custom van builds that we've seen actually take this into account. This is our first time noticing this as a major issue, but we sleep there. We don't want to be sleeping on mold. Luckily, we've had a mattress protector on ours, so we took that off and there's no mold on the actual mattress. If you have a bed platform, make sure to check for this. Not fun.
Pee-pee.
What do you think?
Oh yeah, well this is usually his bad juju corrector. Yeah, you know what this is, don't you, buddy? Don't you, buddy?
Is that a friend?
No, not a friend.
What is happening?
So I'm up here messing around with the old outlet for the TV. When I pulled the face of the outlet off, a stink bug is crawling around. It's a thing on the East Coast, especially like North Carolina and the Virginias. In fall and throughout the winter, the stink bugs will actually find a place to spend the winter. So they'll come inside of your house or your RV. I've literally thrown 3 of them out today. And I'm probably gonna stop throwing them out. I think they're just gonna go into the vacuum cleaner. If you've been watching the channel for a while, there was a time where we didn't cook any meat inside the RV, like at all. But then over the last year, we've reintroduced bacon and all this greasy stuff. Since then, the Maxx fan Deluxe has gotten a workout and it is proper disgusting. I'm breaking it down now so I can clean it. And I'm not gonna lie, I like the Maxx fan Deluxe because it has its own rain cover. But trying to clean this thing is making me not like it so much anymore because it's a process. Also, the motor has died. And I'm only assuming that it's because of condensation and grease and all kinds of stuff getting into it.
Something so satisfying about cleaning something, going from dirty to clean. Anyone else out there like that?
I love it.
Happy anniversary, babe. You get a clean Maxx fan.
We're not big into celebrating anniversaries. We do a lot of fun activities on random days of the year where we feel really lucky and special and together and connected, so just because it's our anniversary doesn't necessarily mean we have to go all out. This year, we're celebrating 6 years and scrubbing a Maxx air vent.
I'm super annoyed. I've pulled the fan apart twice now. We tested the lift motor while I was cleaning it, and it spun when we put a 12-volt external source to it, so I was thinking that probably the circuit board and the fan was failed, but no. I already ordered a new circuit board, went through all this rigmarole to try to weatherproof it with some stuff that I found online, and lo and behold, when I put it all back together, fan motor still don't work. Luckily, I also ordered the bits and bobs that I needed to convert it to manual lift. It's easy to do, it's just WTF, man. I don't know, the longer I have an RV, the less automatic stuff I want to have on the RV. I don't want an automatic awning. I don't want an automatic step anymore. And I don't want an automatic lift on my fan.
The step that's supposed to go in and out automatically, yeah, it doesn't do that anymore. It hasn't done that for months. We've had so many people driving down the road like, your step's out. We're like, yeah, we know we can't fix it. We've tried, and then it just starts acting up again. Trying to do projects on the road can really suck. It truly is one of the worst parts, I think, of full-time RV life. So we are very grateful to be able to have a place to come home to. We're at my sister's house. We've been here for all of winter. We have full hookups here, all of the tools we could ever need. So it makes getting projects checked off the list much, much easier. We're not gonna be showing you the stairs because when we film it, it takes that much longer to do the project, but trust us. We've been working hard behind the scenes here on a lot of stuff on the RV. Thankfully, the next project we have all of the stuff for, and it's a really exciting one.
We have been wanting to upgrade our battery bank in our RV for quite a while. When we first started renovating, we only had the budget for 2 lithium-ion batteries because they are a pretty penny. But we finally were able to work with Renogy to get us that third battery. We've had space down there all along, just waiting for the final 100 amp beautiful battery, and it's here. So thank you, Renogy, for hooking us up. We used Renogy on our first solar install. We ended up going with a kit. It gave us 300 watts of solar panels. It came with the solar charge controller and all of the equipment we needed to do the installation. So it was really, really nice on our fifth wheel. We ended up piecing different pieces together on the Class C RV, but if you are looking for any solar components for your RV, if you want to do more boondocking, and just kind of trying to rely a little bit less on electricity and being hooked up to the grid, we highly recommend going with Renogy. They have a huge product line, everything from solar panels, charge controllers, inverters, and lithium-ion batteries. We'll have a link in the description of the video below if you are interested in checking out their products. Shopping through our link helps our channel out at no extra cost to you. Dennis was able to go up on the roof. A lot of you have followed along. Our solar panels ended up failing when we were in Mexico, so we haven't had solar for quite some time. But thankfully, we ended up getting our solar panel sent back to us. They're brand new, totally replaced and fixed, and we're going to be doing some major improvements to our roof before we reinstall those. So we've gotten the panels off of the roof, but more to come on what's happening with that in a future videos. So there will be many more boondocking adventures in our future. We're going to be heading out west this year, so we have lots of fun, beautiful, cool places to camp. We know we haven't been posting very regularly for you guys lately, so we really appreciate all the comments and people reaching out to check in if we're okay. Everything is fine. We just have a lot going on behind the scenes, and we're kind of taking that pressure off of us to put content out consistently each week. We haven't been traveling very much. We've just been working on projects, working on us, and yeah. But we will be posting more regularly. We have a lot of really amazing adventures coming up, including some international travel. I'd love to see if any of you guys can guess where we're heading. We'll have some very fun videos coming soon, but I just wanted to thank you for watching, for caring, and for being a part of our journey.
I was coming back from the grocery store and a bird shit on me. And it like splattered all over the helmet, and then a little bit of it got on my shirt, some of it on the bike.
Mm-hmm. Is that good luck or something?
I don't know what that means. It was an ibis though, and I was like staring at them like this, so I'm glad I didn't keep looking up at them because then it would have went in the helmet.
Gross.
So at least that, yeah.
Well, there's that whole bottle.